Excellency Mr. Mehdi, Honor Dost, Ambassador of the Islamic Republic of Iran, Honorable Parliamentarians, Excellencies, Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum. It is my profound pleasure to join you all to celebrate the 40th anniversary of the glorious Iranian Revolution. I avail this opportunity to convey on behalf of the President of Pakistan, Excellency Dr. Arif Alvi, the Prime Minister of Pakistan, Mr. Imran Khan, the Parliament, and on behalf of the people of Pakistan, our sincere felicitations and prayers to the Rehbar-e-Inqilab, the President, the Majlis-e-Islami, and to the brotherly people of Iran. Pakistan and Iran share 7 decades of close fraternal relations, which have grown stronger over the years. Both Tehran and Islamabad understand and appreciate each other's position on different regional and international issues. Iran's ties with Pakistan have obtained a special status after the Islamic Revolution. Pakistan was one of the first countries to recognize the change. Both countries have supported each other at critical moment of history. We both are linked by common culture, language, history, and religion. The rich heritage of two nations is the biggest asset of friendship and mutual respect between the two countries. For centuries, our people have sought wisdom and guidance from the writings and thought of Sheikh Sadi, Hafiz Shirazi, and Allama Muhammad Iqbal. The Mirzas, Qazalbash, Begs, Lukmanis, Mashadis, and many other tribes inhabiting almost in all the provinces of Pakistan trace their genetic links to the sacred soil of your country and so are emotionally attached to Iran. Ladies and gentlemen, the PTI government is desirous to enhance its relation with Iran in every possible manner. Our leadership's endeavors are aimed at further consolidating and in strengthening the bilateral ties in all fields. As founding members of ECO, Pakistan and Iran are closely working together towards greater integration of the ECO region. We will boost economic ties and make the whole region a symbol of peace and prosperity through enhanced connectivity and greater economic dependence. Excellency, I'm also pleased to recall that in my former position as the Speaker of the National Assembly, I had the pleasure of taking our relationship to the next level by forging closer parliamentary cooperation. I am glad to note that ever since, the two parliaments have continued to play a significant role in further strengthening these ties. I cannot forget the warmth and hospitality of my Iranian brother and sisters, which was extended to me and the Pakistan delegation during my 2 visits to Iran as the Speaker of the National Assembly of Pakistan. My visit in Iran 2010 was the first by any Pakistani speaker in more than a decade, which in fact revived the parliamentary contacts. This was duly reciprocated, and the Speaker of Iranian Majlis, Excellency Dr. Ali Narajani also visited Pakistan. Ever since then, regular exchange of parliamentary delegations has surely helped us in understanding each other's point of views on variety of issues. We greatly value Iran's consistent support to Pakistan on various issues, particularly Supreme Leader's statement in support of the people of Indian occupied Kashmir. Pakistan believed that Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, GCPOA, represented a good example of a negotiated settlement of complex issues through dialogue and diplomacy. Pakistan had fully supported JCPOA and would continue to endorse Iran's principal stance on this issue. In the end, I once again congratulate you, Excellency, and thank you for your kind hospitality. May the brotherly Islamic Republic of Iran prosper and progress, and may the friendship between our nations continue in future. Ameen. Pakistan Zindabad, Pakistan Iran Dosti Zindabad.